I started in Sector67 about 5 years ago. I got a mechanical engineering degree. We are a community workspace. It's also called a hackerspace or a makerspace. We're essentially a gym club that allows people to come in and work on building things. We're now, 5 years later, up to about 100 members consistently. All of our membership is month to month, so people, of course, come and go as they've got projects and tools and are in town and otherwise. But more specifically, we've got lots and lots of people working on lots of different projects. Everything from people making costumes, Halloween's coming up, so we've got a lot of interest in those things, all the way back to somebody just needing to fix their car and be able to get to work on Monday. So many members working on many different things. I will say one of the most valuable things is seeing over time as these tools get more and more accessible, whether it's 3D printing or laser cutting or machining or any number of things, or just hands-on fabrication. We've seen these tools progressively get simpler and progressively get more and more open to more people, to the point now where you don't need to have an engineering degree to use a lot of these things. You can sit down, you can figure it out, and you can work your way through it in a safe way that's going to ultimately allow you to accomplish something successfully. So, and having the machine actually only for about a week, really, if you count, once we got it, we had to find some space in our shop. We're a little bit tight in here, so getting a little bit of room cleared out to get it set up. Having set that up and getting it going, the first thing we played around with was actually the passive tool probe, which is really cool. We've never had one and we've never been able to play around with it, so we spent a little bit of time reading the manual, which was a good place to start, and getting things adjusted and squared up, and it's within about 2/10,000ths of an inch now that we're able to get precise and repeatable measurements. And so being able to go into the conversational mode and say, find the corner of my stock was awesome. And it was way better than sitting there with an edge finder trying to find the edge and figuring out where our tool was and setting the offset wrong and watching the cutter cut air because we were off by a half inch or whatever. And it was a lot easier to do that than it was normally. So that's been something we played around with, and it sounds like a bit of a gimmick until you mess with it and then you realize how much time you save on it. But second to that, getting it set up, and like I said, we were cutting out some trailer parts for a motorcycle, and we'll see how that project progresses. He's got some more welding work to do and some other things to get those pieces actually joined up, but that'll be a fun project. So one other thing we did on the machine right off the bat is we fired up the conversational mode and set it up to engrave, and we just put a piece of acrylic in just to see how it'd come out, and it came out really well. I think one of the biggest challenges we'll have is keeping people away from it. Every time we fired it up, you get a giant group of people watching the thing run and seeing what's going on. One of the other big advantages of this machine is being able to run flood coolant. So being able to set it up and knowing that you're getting good chip clearances and getting all the chips away from the cutter is really helpful. We've already seen tooling wear a lot lower than what we were getting on our other machine, and I think that's going to be really helpful for being able to spend less time educating people about babysitting the cutter and more time talking about how to make those patterns and make the tool pass to get the thing going and making parts, rather than talking about all the ways of not making parts properly. So that, I think, is going to be one of the biggest, most helpful things with it, is just setting it up, hitting go, and knowing that it's going to run consistently every time. So when I created Sector67, you know, I didn't really know what I was getting into or what I was getting into be teaching all these people how to use a lot of the tools and a lot of the equipment. And over time, as we've grown, I've grown in awareness and understanding about how to use a lot of equipment. When I started, I'd never used a laser cutter, I've never used a CNC router, never used a milling machine that was fully automated. We actually didn't have access to a CNC machine at school. We were still running parts off by hand. I was one of the sort of last graduates who left the machine shop before they had really gotten a lot of CNC equipment that was accessible. So having graduated with that and then having started the space, and today now I need to know how all the equipment works and to be able to train people on how to use all this stuff. That's been a really valuable experience over time to have gone myself through the process of learning these things to the process of teaching others. And I will definitely agree that you'll never learn how to use something better than teaching somebody else how to use it, because you realize things that you took for granted or assumptions that you made are all things that people don't know. So having to go through and train people up on how to use the equipment has been something really been valuable to me as a person, to grow and learn in that capacity and being able to teach people things. You never start as a good teacher, you learn how to be a better one. So it's been fun to progress in that as well.